Okay, so apparently Shay touched his cat, Emma did a blackface, and Jane Charles is racist, and let's get into it straight after this intro.
You like that? Do you like it when mama licks you? No, let me love you!
Oh my god.
Do you love it?
In the fast lane, we play our cards. Praying we'll find out just who we are.
Bitch, I've been the king. What up, everyone? It's your boy, Martin Lewis.
It's your boy, Martin Lewis.
Martin Lewis.
Boy, Martin Lewis.
What up, everyone? It's your boy. Boy, Martin Lewis. Team Real, welcome to my channel where I call out fake up bitch and talk about YouTube drama. And just so y'all guys know, it's like the afternoon, it's 5 o'clock, the sun's gonna go down soon, so I might have to do a voiceover because I'm in Bali and I don't have my lighting, so yeah, just a disclaimer. Also, take your headphones out because I am gonna have loud noises, your ear might get busted. Okay, so there's been a lot of drama trending over the internet. I know there's this whole Romeo thing and I might get into that in another video.
Oh my god, why does he look like a colorful snake?
I definitely want to talk about how it's so obvious that he's lying through the, you know, the language of the particular words that he's using, and I'll do that in another video. But today we're going to be talking about Shane Dawson allegedly doing some things with his cat.
You just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
And I'm going to tell you my thoughts as a mixed boy. Do I think Emma Chamberlain, is it Emma Chamberlain? Emma, you know who I'm talking about, this girl right here. Did she do blackface? And how James Charles also got his revenge on a troll. We're gonna get all into that today, okay? So if you guys are new to this channel, make sure to hit the subscribe button with the bell so you don't miss out on any of the drama. Smash that like button, and if you guys have any story or leads, all my social media links are in the description below. So let's get straight into the drama. So as you guys know, y'all should know who Shane Dawson is, okay? Please don't ask me to explain who the fuck Shane Dawson is, or James Charles, or Emma, whatever her name is, okay? You should know who she is. Y'all watch these people more than I do. Maybe a year or two or so, Shane Dawson used to have a podcast. In his podcast, he used to make a lot of edgy jokes, say a lot of crazy things. And now, you know, 2018, 2019, he's been copying a lot of ish for the things that he has said in the past. Now, recently, there's been a video flying around of Shane Dawson talking about doing some stuff with his cat.
There you go. The things I've done to my poor animals, they will never love me. Mm. The terrible things. I used to...
Oh, no. I don't know if you want to go there, Shane. What'd you do?
One time, I laid my cat down on her back.
You won't get arrested for this?
I don't know. No.
Think about it.
I don't think so.
Okay, go ahead.
I laid the cat down on her back, and then I moved her little chicken legs, like, you know, spread open or whatever. And I was like, if I just, like, but, like, on her tummy, like, that's not weird. Like, whatever. And then I... And it kept going all over the cat.
No, you did not.
It was like my first sexual experience.
No,
I was also
way.
Like 19, so it's like, you know.
Wait a minute.
Wait a second. Did you just say you kept on a cat?
Guys, I think I have to put money in the meter.
Yeah, right.
But you know, who likes cats? I never did anything like that. Well, I never did anything crazy like that.
Maybe that's
dog.
Why you don't like anymore.
That's meant to be a joke because it's so serious. He was so, like, the way he was talking, I was like, oh my god. Now, people were saying at the end of the joke, he says he's never done that anything crazy to the cat.
I never did anything crazy like that.
Maybe that's why you don't.
But if you listen carefully, it doesn't sound like he says anything about the cat. Or saying that, oh no, it's not serious, I'm just joking. It sounds like he said he's never done anything that crazy to a dog.
Let me know what you think, what he said.
And it's so weird, like, how he remembers how old he was, or in the joke he remembers how old he was. You know when people tell you, like, something that funny that happened to them in their past, like, oh my god, girl, I was so drunk, and, like, I my pants, and it was, like, so disgusting, and they, like, laugh about it, or I a cup because there was nowhere to pee. It's like he was talking as if he didn't know it was wrong. Now he does, but back then he didn't see it as something that was bad, if that makes sense. He saw it as something like, oh my god, I was 19 and being dumb and it was funny. You know? After this went all over Twitter, Shane went on his Twitter and addressed it and said, which, at least, you know, all these YouTubers always run away from all the bad-ish. So, to me, it's like, you know what? At least he's addressing it. But anyway, this is what he says. I didn't eat my cat. I didn't come on my cat. I didn't put my anywhere near my cat. I've never done anything weird with my cats. I promised myself I wasn't going to make apology videos after last year's thing. So, I'm just trying to be as short and honest with this as possible. I've apologized many times for all the dumb shit I've said in my videos and podcasts over the years. I've learned my lesson over and over again, and I'm more confident now in my ability to be entertaining by just being myself and not being so shocking for laughs. That story was fake and was based on a dumb, awful sketch idea I had years ago that I never made, thank God. And when the opportunity came up for a funny moment in the podcast, I told it as if it was a real story, which was disgusting and very, very dumb. Oh, hell yeah! Like, how old were you then to be thinking that ish was funny and that it was normal? Okay, let's keep watching. I meant reading. My goals in the podcast of my videos years ago was to tell shocking stories that would make people laugh and scream, oh my god, no you didn't, and think I was so crazy. It's embarrassing and I effing hate myself for it. Now that I'm making stuff I love and I'm being myself, it feels so much better. And I finally feel like I'm putting my stuff out in the world that means something. I'm not saying I hate everything I've made over the years. There's so many things I'm so proud of, but all of my offensive jokes, over the top stories, insensitive jokes are something that still haunt me and something I have to be faced with every day on the internet. And it never gets easier. So I'm sorry for what I said about my cat. I'm sorry for what I said about anything or anyone that was offensive. And I'm sorry for being someone who thought being super offensive and shocking all the time was funny. I'm sorry for the past, but I'm really to make it right. But I'm really to make it right. I think he meant willing. I feel like without my past, I wouldn't be who I am today, and I wouldn't be able to grow and spend my energy on things that actually mean something. This has been the best 2 years of my life, and it's because I've been able to drop and act and be myself. And I'm sorry for not doing it sooner. Okay, let me know in the comment section below, do you think Shane was serious? Or do you think it was just a stupid, edgy joke? There was no, like, sarcastic tone to it. It was just really weird. And really, maybe it really didn't mean to come out that way, and it was meant to come out a different way. I don't know. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comment section below. Look, at the end of the day, I don't hate Shane. I'm just gonna, you know, I'm not gonna put my goldfish near him, my cat, my dog. I don't want any of my pets near him, okay? Put a tracking device on him. Make sure he don't go to the zoo, the pet store. Whatever it was or whatever he was trying to do, if he was trying to be shocking, it was so dumb and so stupid, okay? So let's move on to the next drama. Okay, so there's this troll named Javon, okay? Javon Hill. Apparently, he's a bum and he begs people for money. But honestly, I'm starting to think that this guy isn't a bum. Like, because technically speaking, he's getting paid to troll people online. If he wasn't doing all that stuff, I'm pretty sure no one would just give him money freely. Or would they? I don't know, maybe all the people that donate to him have white guilt or something, I don't know. He ended up tweeting saying, Prince Charles is racist, Shane Dawson is racist, Emma Chamberlain is racist, you defend them, you're a racist. Now he then tweeted this of James Charles messaging him the N-word, but it wasn't actually James Charles sending him the N-word. It's actually fake, and we're gonna get into that later on. James Charles said, this is absolutely not funny. Delete this immediately or my lawyer will be in contact. Let's do it, baby. I know the law. He ended up responding to someone if he was gonna take him to court. James said, I don't wanna give him the thrill of even taking him to court. Twitter is already helping me handle it. James, literally, take a joke. Getting messages of death threats and emails questioning one's character over a fake screenshot is not a joke. Dumbass threatening a law student with your little makeup palette. I really hate when white women threaten to sue me, like legit makes me mad because you know they can't read. James' lawyer must have told him he can't sue. Now, because James Charles gave this guy so much attention by that one little tweet, he ended up selling some merch. Some people thought it was a marketing trick to sell his brand, his clothes or whatever. But honestly, no, I think he was just trolling, and then later on he was like, you know what, I'm gonna plug my shirt into this. Now, a lot of people got involved in this, one of them being Sebastian. This person made a fake DM of James Charles and now wants James to sue him. This is literally defamation. The intention of this person is to hurt James' reputation based on a lie. This tweet of him proves he has malicious intentions regarding James. I'm disgusted. James ended up getting his revenge and suspended this guy for like 12 hours. It wasn't a big deal. But the troll got pissed, man. Y'all, he would try to act cool and calm, but really, he was really pissed. And he was just bashing James Charles, consistently talking about him that whole day.
We're going international. We're hitting every box. I will wait 12 hours, bitch, because I don't fuck with that. Oh, I can't say that word. I don't fuck with that. Thanks.
For me, if he really was, this really good troll, I don't think his emotions would have been so involved, because you watched that stream and he was really pissed. It's like he was trying to really hurt James, you know? Like, there's trolls that say stuff and everyone laughs about it, okay? Everyone finds it funny, it's a troll. But there's a difference between a troll and being a malicious little because you're mad. This guy was definitely trying to take advantage of black people's emotions so he can grow on Twitter. Someone tries to take advantage of your emotions by making fake tweets, fake messages to like get you riled up and angry and to spread their so you can market them for free, basically. James Charles did not send that. Now let's move to Emma Chamberlain, okay? Oh my god, bro. Long ago, she made like this fashion video, top dress or some weirdish like that.
Yeah, today. I'm gonna give myself a full makeover just with stuff that I bought from the dollar store.
And she ended up looking like this. So this picture is flying all over Twitter. It's being edited. Some people have showed the real one, which is this one, and people are showing this one and saying, oh no, she doesn't look like this. It's like, nah, she looked like that when she's in the back of the room of the video. This one is when she's at the front of the room and the light is more pressured on her face. But anyway, she ended up putting a chef outfit type of thing.
I got this nice little chef dress.
You're a f***ing idiot.
Some would think it was an apron. I just would disagree. I already look great.
Already people are like, oh good lord, now she's trying to dress like a slave. She then gets a green hat and puts it on the side.
That is so fucking cute. Oh my god, let's put it on the side of the head.
She then pretends that she mistakenly picks up the dark foundation or whatever. Maybe she really did, but I think she's just saying she did so she could be funny.
We're probably gonna break out from this. We're gonna be using the Sassy and Chic BB Beauty Cream in the shade Dark. That was an accident. I forgot to check what shade I would be, and I am definitely not dark, so we will see how that goes. Jersey Shore.
Get crazy, get wild.
So good. Don't forget to blend down your neck. That's what all the beauty gurus say. One of my nails just fell off. It's okay.
Then she puts big ass red lipstick on.
I have a feeling that this might be poisonous.
Okay, so let me know in the comment section below, do you think Emma is purposely doing blackface? let me know. I have a theory and I have a thought of what I think happened. Now, this is what I think happened. I honestly think she mistakenly got this not realizing what it was gonna look like, and it ended up looking like that. Because a lot of girls walking around with that type of dark shade of makeup on, okay? For real. Because there are a lot of stupid ladies out there that wear that kind of dark shade of makeup that don't match their skin. But then she has that green hat, she has the chef thing, you're just like... Oh. So I had to go on Google and go by the definition. What is blackface, and is Emma doing what is the definition of blackface? Cool. Blackface is a form of theatrical makeup used to predominantly...
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine.
Used predominantly by non-black performers to represent a character of a black person. So with blackface, people are usually trying to act as a stereotype. Now, was Emma acting like a stereotype?
Oh. Anyways. Now this, my friends, is the completed makeover.
Emma, blackface. Emma, someone trying to look like Nicki Minaj. Emma, blackface and some emo dude. Emma, blackface.
Here comes my theory that makes me think maybe, just like Jahava, whatever that guy's name is, maybe she was trying to use black people's emotions to go viral. So she pretended she didn't know what she was doing by wearing the chef thing, the green hat, the big red lipstick, the shade that's not even black, it's just a darker shade. Maybe she knew that will make people mad and spread her video and the video will go viral. But then if that was the case, why did she delete it? She hasn't really addressed this also speaks volume. How hard is it to go, hey, I got this stuff not realizing it was gonna look a particular way and I am so sorry. You know what I mean? Like, oh my god, this rain. So guys, let me know in the comment section below, what do you think? Do you think she purposely did that to do blackface? Or did she do it without realizing what she was doing? I want to know your thoughts in the comment section below. Anyway guys, make sure to hit the subscribe button with the bell, because if you don't, Shane Dawson's going to come on you when you're sleeping. So you better hit the subscribe button. And I'll see you guys in another drama video.